Ohayou gozaimasu, or konbanwa. Welcome to this first episode of Mark Cooks Japanese Food, and today I'm going to be trying to prepare tamagoyaki.
Right, let's cook Japanese omelette. Okay, the ingredients: a pinch of salt and a good teaspoonful of sugar. This is dashi stock. This is mirin, and we have 6 eggs. So add a teaspoon full of mirin, add the dashi stock, this is optional, and the sugar and salt. There's many different ways of making this. This is one of the more sort of complicated ways with more ingredients. And whisk the eggs. Don't beat them into a frenzy, but you want to make sure that it's completely mixed and all the white has gone into the yellow. Take a pan and add some oil. Vegetable oils are perfect for this. You don't want any strong flavoured oils that can mask the flavour of the egg. Give it a good swirl round and then drain the extra oil away. Take a bit of the egg and just drip it in, and if it starts to cook, you know it's ready. The pan is at the right temperature. Take a good ladle full of the egg mixture. Give it a good swirl round to cover all the pan. Pop any air bubbles with your chopsticks. Slowly tease the egg away if it's starting to stick slightly, and begin the folding process. You want it to resemble a kind of pancake, then re-oil the pan, slide it all to one end, and apply some more egg mixture. Basically repeat the process, making sure that you get plenty of the egg mixture underneath the already cooked egg to stop it from burning. Once the egg starts to get about 70 to 80% cooked, then roll back over again. Try to keep it into a square sort of shape, or an oblong shape. Re-oil. Make sure the whole pan's coated, including the side lips. Slide the egg to one side. Remaining egg mixture.
Before eating, it's customary to say itadakimasu. This is the equivalent of saying grace. Chopsticks should be placed on a chopstick rest when not in use, and definitely not used to fiddle around with or play the drums. It's actually improper to stick the chopsticks directly into the rice like this, as this resembles sticking incense sticks into rice or sand at a funeral ritual. When pouring the soy sauce, when handed to you, use just a very small amount. Don't fill the soy sauce pot right to the top, as this shows sort of no respect for the host's ingredients that he's given to you. It's sort of looked at as greedy. Simply pour a small amount in, and then when that has depleted, then just refill to the same amount. If we adopted this style in the West, then we wouldn't have to keep going to the supermarkets in order to replenish our stocks of tomato ketchup. Never smother your food with the soy sauce, as this shows no respect for the chef's cooking abilities. It's the same as putting tons and tons of salt on your food.
Again, make sure that the already cooked egg gets a load of the egg mixture underneath. Just lift it up and let it sort of drizzle under. Again, 70% to 80% cooked, and roll over. If you're skilled, you don't need to use your hands, but I do need to use my hands for this final one due to it being a bit heavy. And there you have it. Take it out, put it on a board, and let it cool. Use some kitchen towel to get rid of any excess extra oil. You want it as dry as possible. You don't want a greasy fried egg style omelette. Take the end pieces off, which look untidy, and you can obviously just eat them, and then slice into equal portions. As you can see, the layers are clearly visible. So prepare your plate with some salad and some pickled ginger, and arrange on a plate. You can add a dash of wasabi paste on top, and there is the final thing. Tamago yaki. Itadakimasu.
Next Sunday long cooks sushi.